very entertaining and splendid afternoon. What you just heard was Trailblazing, a fun clarinet duet that I wrote, and it mimics the sounds of hiking through the mountains and waterfalls, all that fun stuff, as you heard in those fun runs. And I very much enjoyed playing that. Really gets me out of breath, so I'll do my best. This next piece that you're about to hear, as you can tell by the title, Variations on a Fairly Simple Idea, is in theme and variations form. It came as kind of a last minute effort to put something on my clarinet recital last semester, but it ended up turning into something that I really enjoyed. The fairly simple idea that you'll hear right at the beginning will be presented to you, and then you'll hear a couple of variations on that theme. So I challenge you to try to hear each of that theme and each of the variations, okay? And it'll be done on this big old bass clarinet right here. So please enjoy Variations on a Fairly Simple Idea. Thank you. I've since been informed that it's not a boogie, so it's now a groove. So please enjoy the clarinet groove, and please welcome the clarinet studio here at BYU-I.
Thank you.
we got a pretty big set change right here. So we're taking care of that. The next piece that you're about to listen to is entitled Music Box Lullaby. Originally written, I would say three semesters ago in the winter of 2023. It was written for the percussion methods course, which on this campus, methods courses are designed to help people understand each instrument better, to better teach for them. But in my case, I took it to better compose for these instruments, right? So knowing that I was in this class, I was able to write a piece for that calls for two marimbas, a vibraphone, a glockenspiel, which is this dingly guy up here, as well as the celeste, which will bring me in a second. It was based on an idea that I recorded on the piano. On my phone, I have close to 300 recordings of just ideas that when I sit down at the piano, I just record myself and it gives me material to work with, right? And this was one of them. As you'll hear, the main theme is very, very lovely. It sounds like this. And I was like, oh, that sounds like a music box, and it's very pretty, and it's nice and simple, and I thought it would work well for the song. So please enjoy the next couple of minutes as we play this piece. Feel free to pull out your blankets and pillows that y'all brought. Take a nap if you please. And please enjoy a music box. Love it. Thank you. excited about and I'm also really nervous about because I have not practiced this piece, okay? As you see on your programs, it's entitled Piano Improvisation, okay? And just to give you a little brief backstory about who I am as a composer, I took piano lessons for about 7 or 8 years growing up, and my story was like most, where I hated practicing, and eventually I quit, right? Because I loved music, but I hated practicing that thing. And so I was like, you know, I'm done. I don't want to do this, right? But I was still in like band, I still knew a lot about music, and I really loved it still. And so after quitting piano lessons, I played even more, which sounds a little bit backwards because most people stop right there and then they regret it a couple years on. But that decision to quit piano lessons actually changed my whole compositional career because then I started loving the piano because I didn't have to play it anymore, right? And so I started playing songs by ear. I remember just doing my favorite songs and I was like, oh, this song sounds cool, can I play it on the piano? And I would just pluck out the notes, right? Then there was one day where you'll hear this at the very last piece of this recital, you'll hear the very first melody I ever came up with, right? But I was sitting at the piano, I had this idea and I put it on the piano, put some chords behind it, and boom, I had made my first song. It wasn't crazy, it's not that good, it's very basic, uses like a pop chord progression, just four repeating chords. But to me, that was my first step. And since then, I've enjoyed doing everything by ear. It's actually one of my biggest strengths. So I thought I would include it on this recital, I just didn't know how. But I was thinking, okay, what if I made a song right here, right now, based on what you guys tell me, okay? So I'm just gonna need two things, okay? Let's see, Maddie, can you give me a key signature? Just any key signature, your favorite one. A flat major, that's one of my favorites. You picked a good one. I didn't force her to say that. So my piece is gonna revolve mostly around A flat major. I can't promise where it goes anywhere in the middle. And I also, Daniel Ash, can you sing me like a 5 to 10 note, like 2 second melody? Just sing whatever comes to mind. Just make something up.
Can I swing it?
Sure. Correct? Something like that. You like that?
Yeah.
Okay, wait, that's A flat, that's A minor though. And you said A flat major. Is everyone okay with that? Everyone okay with that? it's called Homeward Bound. It's one of my favorite songs. I'd sung it in state choir growing up, and it had always been one of my favorite choir arrangements that I'd done. So when I was looking to mash up a song with Savior Redeemer of My Soul, this one popped into my head. It's the same time signature. I could put it in the same key. It has the same tempo, vibe to it. And originally, I had written this piece back in winter of 2019, my second semester here. I'd written it for the four clarinets and bass clarinet that we had in our studio back then. And we took it on tour, we played it a couple times, and it was lots of good fun, right? And then I was in for the Wahlquist scoring and arranging class, and we had to arrange something for wind quintet, as you see in front of you. And I was like, wait, I thought about this piece, I was like, oh, I could probably just rearrange it for wind quintet. And so I did. And this was back in fall of last year, I guess, back in fall of 2022. We played it in wind quintet, and it got accepted to be played at devotional. So that following semester, we played this piece at devotional as well. And that was one of the highlights of my compositional career here, that the entire school be able to listen to one of my little arrangements was a great honor. Okay? And so, that's it. Just pay attention at the very end. I'm very proud of this. It was hard to do. But at the climax of the piece, I mixed both of the melodies together. You'll hear it between the clarinet and the horn for one of the melodies and the flute and the oboe on the other while Abby keeps his fruit. So please enjoy this arrangement of Savior Redeemer of My Soul.
Thank you.
is a pretty weird piece. It's entitled Alpha Set. Now, for those of you who've taken musicianship before, you know what set theory is. It's this concept in music where you ditch key centers and forget this normal sound in music. They say, hey, what if we put a group of notes together, right? So the alpha set is a group of these four notes. It is like a major chord with that minor third. Yeah, nice dissonant sound, very enjoyable, very fun, right? So I built an entire piece around that. And to make it even more weird, I wrote an electronic my first stab at writing a vocal piece. And it got pushed off like, what, 3 semesters? And every time I saw him, I'm like, Joseph, I'm so sorry, I'm gonna give you that piece, okay, I'll get you it. And then he sends me all these like poems that I can set to music. And finally, with the occasion of the senior recital, I finally got it done. Because, well, one, I needed a vocal piece on this recital. But two, I really wanted to do it before I graduate, because then I would lose this resource, right? So please enjoy Song Cycle for tenor voice and piano.
Thank you.
coming here to visit us and listen to some hopefully good music, sorry. we're now going to finish exactly how it all began, with a suite of beginnings. Like I mentioned, what you're about to hear, this first movement is the very first idea, hence the name, the first idea, of the very first melody I had ever come up with. And like you'll hear, it's pretty simple, but it means a lot to me, and it's been the start of big things. You'll also hear four other movements after that, all of which are based on some of the earliest songs that I'd ever made. Released melodies, chord progressions, all that jazz. So please, please, please enjoy a suite of beginnings, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your days. Thank you.